Right then, let's talk about that game. It started off Manchester United against Young Boys. It ended Young Boys against Young Boys. Manchester United 1-1 against Young Boys in a game where Zidane Iqbal made his debut. Charlie Savage made his debut. By the way, you know, say what you want about Robbie Savage. That was a pretty beautiful moment. A dad commentating and introducing his son to football. Hey, congrats, man. It was a game where Ralf Rangnick chose opportunity for players rather than winning. It was a bench with hat which had Iqbal on it. It was a bench which had Mengi. It had Kovar, a goalkeeper. It had Heaton. It had Shorotire. It was a bench that didn't have Ronaldo, Rashford, Sancho, Maguire. The whole, basically, first team. That was a team where it was a completely changed 11. And I tell you what, that first half, the first 40 minutes of that first half, were very, very good. Very, very exciting. Manchester United. And the big thing, the one thing I really wanted to see today from Man United was a similar sort of style to what we saw against Crystal Palace. And we saw that in that first 40 minutes. You know, we had Greenwood on there. We had Elanga on there. We had Ahmad. It was weird. We had Van der Beek and Mata as the two central midfielders. Not exactly holding midfielders, were they? I'll get into Van der Beek's performance in a bit. Don't worry about that. A back four of Matic's centre-back. It was a bit like when Carrick dropped back in. Loads of changes, loads of head-scratching about the formation. But ultimately, the first 40 minutes, we played Rangnick ball. We were pressing with intensity. We were pressing as a unit. We played well in that first 40 minutes. And how... Oh, mate. That goal from Greenwood. Ah! Disgusting, man. Come on. Does he not know these kids? They've got families, these young boys players. Come on. You can't be doing that, Greenwood. Unbelievable. Luke Shaw getting an assist within 9 minutes of coming back into the team. Fair play to him. Jesus, though. Can we talk about Wan Bissaka? We've got to talk about Wan Bissaka. He put in an absolute stinker of a game there. I mean, I honestly don't know how they've got him down here as a 7.4. They've got him down there as a 7.4. Have they done that? Wan Bissaka, not only was he involved in that first goal, the equaliser. We've got to talk about that first, surely, probably. Apologies. Van der Beek, really bad mistake, man. Really bad mistake. When you're playing in that position, you cannot afford to make those mistakes. Wan Bissaka did a really sloppy header to keep the ball on the pitch. But then Wan Bissaka, it was just bad all round. Bad all round. A great finish, but bad all round. A self-inflicted problem. And they nearly scored a second toward the end of that first half. United had control in that first 40 minutes, and we lost control in the last 5 minutes of that first half. Going into the second half, it was quite similar, actually, to what we saw against Crystal Palace. United didn't come out at the races in the second half. And Young Boys were in the game, controlling the game. Manchester United really, really lost control of that game. And I'm not sure we ever got it back. And let's be honest, when you've got a bench of Iqbal, and you've got a bench of Savage, of Shorotire, of Kovar, of Mengi, you're not going to be able to change the game from the bench. As I said, it was a game where, and I stand by Rangnick's decision there. I would much rather have seen that tonight and the opportunity for players to prove themselves or not prove themselves, as was the case with some, then for us to play Ronaldo, play Rashford, play Fred and McTominay, and then, you know, cruise to a 3-0 win. Of course, that would have been brilliant, but it wouldn't have changed anything in the course of the... We're top of the group. We are top of the group. That was done and dusted. And Rangnick, this was only his second game in charge. We had 3 games in 7 days, and we've got another game in 3 days. It's all about player management, right? And that's what he did tonight. So if you're looking at people that... I thought Wan Mata, if you're looking at a midfield two between Van der Beek and Mata and who you expected to play better... I would have expected Van der Beek to play better. I'll be honest, I thought Mata played better. I thought Van der Beek didn't. It was a mixed bag from Donny, right? Let's be completely fair and completely frank. It was a mixed bag from Donny Van der Beek. Sometimes it was good, sometimes it may be good, sometimes it may be shit. Now, I think that's how you can sum his performance up, right? I don't think he really played himself into a team. I'll tell you who has played himself in to start against Norwich, right? Mason Greenwood's got to start against Norwich, hasn't he? After that performance there, against Young Boys, after that goal against Young Boys. Ah, that was filth, absolute filth. And Marcus Rashford is a man who is struggling with form right now. So I would absolutely start him in that game against Norwich at the weekend. Overall, you've got to be disappointed, I suppose, with how different the first 40 minutes were compared to the last 50. But on the one hand, we made 11 changes, Sam. Of course, it was going to be that sort of game. And I think you're completely right there. We, you know, yeah, we did make 11 changes. So for me, as I said, the main thing I was looking for tonight was some sort of continuity. My buzzword of the season so far, if Rangnick's buzzword is control, mine is continuity. I want to see continuity between performances. I want to see what we did against Crystal Palace and it to get replicated against Young Boys. And I thought we did that for the first 40. We pressed in the shape. We stuck with the 4-2-2. It worked. We were pressing in our zones, pressing with intensity, winning the ball high up the pitch. And our chance creation in that first half was fantastic. Greenwood passing it over to Diallo. He should have taken the shot on himself. Then there was another that we created like two. Wan-Mata, when he got squared back to him, he should have scored from that. We could have and should have been 2 or 3-0 up in the first half, which is exactly what we said against Crystal Palace at the weekend. Ultimately, 1-0 was enough in that game. But we should have been 2-3-0 up in the first half against Palace, and we should have been 2 or 3-0 up in the first half here against Young Boys. So it tells us we've got to be more clinical. Chance creation wasn't a problem in that first half. It should have been dead and buried by the end of the first half, but instead Young Boys got back into it, and because they were chasing something, they stayed in the game. Let's speak about the youngsters who came off the bench that scroll down here. We've got Charlie Savage and Iqbal both came on just before the end. As I said, it was a wonderful moment there for Robbie Savage to commentate on his own boy coming on for Manchester United at Old Trafford in the Champions League. Hell yeah. Congratulations there, Robbie. I'm a big fan of that. Tenen Mengi, got to talk about him. Thought he played very well, actually, at left back. Came on, did, you know, when he slipped and he got back up, Tenen Mengi did himself proud there, but he's a centre back. He's not a left back. But at least he proved himself, right? Shodashuretire, I'll be honest, we weren't really in the game by the time that Shodashuretire came on, so he couldn't really do a thing. And he's not, hasn't got that much presence at that age to change the game on his own. So he couldn't really do much. Tom Heaton, what am I going to say about Tom Heaton? I think maybe that might be a nod to the fact that Dean Henderson could leave on loan in January to Ajax. That's Van der Sar wants him. I spoke about that in my live stream this morning. Maybe Dean Henderson was good as a sweeper keeper in that first like 30 minutes. He was like, look at me. I am Manuel Neuer. But he did it well. When you play a high line, when you play an aggressive line, you need your goalkeeper to be able to do that. And I think Dean Henderson showed that well. Eric Bailly was Eric Bailly tonight. Brilliant, but still made you go, ah! But it was a good side of it tonight. But that's how I feel when I watch Eric Bailly in defence of Manchester United. But the winner for tonight is Mason Greenwood. Definitely man of the match. Unbelievable goal. Really mature performance overall. You look and you feel like something's going to happen when the ball goes to the feet of Mason Greenwood, right? That's what I feel anyway. And the loser of the night for me is Wan Bissaka. Diogo Dalot. Look, right. Some of you might be saying, Sam, you're being too harsh on him. But look at this, right? Diogo Dalot is somebody who we know he's got a natural ability to go forward. But what we've seen from Diogo Dalot in the last couple of games is he's married that with excellent defensive performances. If that was the weak side of his game, the last couple of games, he's really stepped it up. Tackling good, positioning good, not being caught out too often, covering space. Dalot improved massively in the last couple of games. So what Wan-Bissaka needed to do tonight was the stuff that he always does very well. Defensively, sound as a pound. Tackles, no problem. He didn't do that right, let alone going forward, which is where we needed to see improvement from Wan-Bissaka. Tonight was about opportunity. That's what Rangnick chose. As I said, if you wanted to win this game, we would have had Ronaldo starting. We would have had Rashford starting. We would have had Scott McTominay and Fred starting in midfield. And there wouldn't have been opportunities for other players. But instead, he chose to see his team play in a competitive environment in a game which was a dead rubber because we won against Villarreal. Michael Carrick winning that game 2-0 gave us the opportunity there tonight to play some players. Give everyone an opportunity. Now everybody has had a fair chance. No Van der Beek fan can now argue and say he's not been playing. You could say, oh, yeah, but you need to play him alongside X to get X out of him. Cool. But I personally believe Wan-Mata played better in that role than Donny Van der Beek did. And I don't think that does him any favours. Let's see what goes on with Donny. But yeah, everyone got chances tonight. Ahmad, he had his moments. So did Elanga. But I think a lot of the game passed them by, both of them. Same with Jesse Lingard. The only real standout we got from our attack there, in my opinion, was Mason Greenwood. Proper, he's not a talent anymore. He's just a star. He's a straight up star. So yeah, it started off Manchester United versus Young Boys. It ended Young Boys against Young Boys. Tonight was all about opportunities. Tonight was all about debuts. Tonight was all about Ralf Rangnick getting to know his squad. It's not a game that's going to have any sort of impact or influence on our season. The Premier League is. We won 1-0 against Crystal Palace. We came in here. We started brilliantly for 40, but we faded. That's what happens when you play a young team and we had nobody from the bench who could change it against the Young Boys. Let's be honest, got better as the game went on because they could sniff that they had an opportunity. But they fell short. 1-1, I'll take it. Done. Norwich, we move on in a few days and there's going to be another 11 changes. and not maybe not 11. Maybe Greenwood will stay in the team. There's going to be a swathe of changes coming from that Norwich game. Who was your man of the match for me? It's surely it's Mason Greenwood, but you might disagree. Let me know in the comments below. What do you think about Wan Bissaka's performance, Van der Beek's performance, the overall performance of United? You let me know what you think in the comments below. As always, make sure you subscribe if you're new. Take it easy.